Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, a Tear of Vermillion blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, heading towards Beloa, but actually going part of the way there and then detouring to the Sorcery School. Because there's another Swordmaster book there, and we're fighting this, okay? Your funeral. The XP was like bloop. Like, I think we all got one XP or something. Yeah, I wanna try to avoid fighting these things. It's hard to see them until they're right on top of you sometimes. Alright, we're continuing east. Oh. We're littering. And oh, these things are suicidal, practically. I'm pretty sure we go up this way and then we start heading east again, I think. I do not want to fight you. You do not give off good experience. No! No! I said no. When I say no, I mean hell no. Ah, you binding us now? Such a tiny bit of experience. Okay. No, no, wait, kitty. Okay, I don't need that. Hey. That was close. Keep finding me stuff. Okay. So you need to cross this bridge. At least enemies don't appear on bridges for whatever reason. At least, unless they're special enemies, like those assassins. Is this a dead end? It probably is. I'm throwing it away. Oh. A confused charm. Did they repopulate these chests, or did I miss that one? I'm confused by the confused charm. Well, it's not gonna be a potion. It's gonna be an item? Talisman in which the confusion spell is sealed confuses the enemy for a while. Not interested. Not interested. I could not be less interested. I'm looking for that sign. I think this is it. East is Guia. Oh, South Sorcery School. I'm like, why isn't it showing? This is too many. So we'll go talk to everybody here and collect that book from somebody. And then we'll continue on to Guia. They really make you work for these books. No? I see you agree. Alright, it was supposed to be south, and we're going north. Okay, there we are. Greetings! Oh, you're the one who... from the Adventurer Guild, right? Max says, huh? What a surprise! You are Lucius, the Sapphire Eyes. Douglas told me about you. Of course, I had known you before he mentioned you. Do you know him? Lucius asked. I worked with him when we were rookies. We still team up whenever our schedules meet. But he has gone to the Western Continent. Right, Lucia says. A seasoned man with a baby face. You must be Max the Babyface in Guia. I heard about you on the Western Continent. You handle fluently a large sword that doesn't go with your cute face. That's me. Do people in the West know that I have a baby face? I'm happy to know I'm famous, but I also feel sad in a way. By the way, ever since the Siam Seal Gang showed up, I have been patrolling this place regularly. Yeah, no, we left you here last time. The Siam Seal Gang was already arrested, so I don't think you should worry about them anymore. I'm still patrolling here just in case. The world has become a dangerous place. I'm mistaken for a student once in a while. I may not look 27, but... But you are? President Sion says, "Welcome to the Temple of Esoteric Wisdom. The door to truth is open to all mankind. What you have learned may not help you right away, but they will certainly enrich your life." Something dropped from the inner pocket of President Sion's jacket. "You dropped something," says Rutice. Avon says, "It's a novel." "Well, you must learn about worldly things in order to pursue truth," says the president. "Oh well, I confess. It's my hobby." Silence. "Why don't you keep the book?" Even Swordmaster 9. Sweet. That's why we came, but we're gonna look around and talk to everybody. Hello. Hello, may I help you? It's a lecture period, so you can't enter any of the classrooms. That's lame. Excuse me, you can't enter without permission. They're having lectures now, so please refrain from entering the classrooms. I hereby give myself permission. Walks over there every time. Alright. There's somebody hanging out. You know what? Before I start messing around in here, let me go check with him. I can just walk over the stuff. I appreciate them sending an adventurer. I used to patrol the premises myself. I can concentrate on gardening now. Does it require much concentration? We're in the middle of a lecture. You can't enter the classroom. But it looks like we can talk to all of you. Is this same book? Same book? An overview of spirit spells. Yeah. I read that one. Sorcery systems in Elfilden. The genealogy of ancient spells. Yeah, we've read them all. Nothing in here. I'm thinking of someplace else. I thought there was like a tower here or something. Oh. We got the book. I might finish up the episode reading it. Alright, now off to Guia. I must be thinking something else. Because I remember it having a downstairs and towers. What am I thinking of? East is Guia. This is much more than 91 Milos. Man, these snails really go for blood. I can one-shot you guys, or at least our main man can do so. North is Guia. No. East was Guia. Avon says, we're in Guia. Let's see the plant manager right away. Of course, we'll visit Rouca, too. Hey, Avon, Rutice says, could you go to the factory with Lucius? What? Why are you saying that all of a sudden? I thought I found the answer, but I don't deserve to see Rouca just yet. Nonsense. He's your only brother. I haven't found my path yet. I don't want to stand in front of him when I don't know who I am myself. Rutice. Lucia says, if that's how you feel, then so be it. You wait for us at the inn. We'll be back after talking to the plant manager. Thank you, Lucius. I'll be waiting at the inn then. Hey, Rutice, says Avon. Why'd you tell her that, Lucius? Just like you, she has her problem. We shouldn't meddle in. All we can do is to watch out for her so we don't go into a wrong direction. Her brother's name is Rouca, right? Keep your mouth shut in front of him, okay? Okay. Alright, let's go to the factory then. I'm not going to the factory yet. I'm gonna look around. And talk to everybody first. You know me. You might find another book or something, who knows. The productions of iron ore or iron ores are dropping gradually. We have been digging for several hundred years now, so it may well be that the ores are finally running out. We may have to rely on what they call new ore. New ore, huh? Is that lady's house? Oh no, it isn't. This is... Oh! No, this is her and her friend who they have a love-hate relationship or something. I don't want that. Old woman Rayo. Don't bother with what this old croc is saying. He always has too much to say. Oh, we're gonna talk to him anyway. Don't need that. She has the devil's luck. Monsters are wandering about along the highway, but she came home unhurt, escorted by adventurers. Yep. We met up with her over there. Rayo came back from her pilgrimage to the Holy Capital. My father complained about her all the time, but he went to see her merrily. There's a really interesting dynamic going on there. There's the girl with the cat. Everyone at the factory is very busy. Rouca is also too busy to play with me. That's okay with me. I'll play with Maruru. I think she has a cat. It's the cat, right? They say the factory is going to refine a new metal. My husband was very excited to tell me. Men love new inventions. Hey, women love new inventions, too. Inventions are cool. My husband stays late in the mine to find a new ore. I know it's his job, but I'm lonely. Avon's like, hey, can I help you out there, honey? My father spends most of his time at the factory. He is excited to help the factory produce a new metal. I want him to come home more often, but I can't tell him because he looks so full of life. Yeah, when you do see him, he's full of life. The rest of the time, he's just not there. What a shame. Oh, we can't get in that way, can we? Yeah, we can't walk that way either. Didn't stop me from trying. Alright, so let's check down here. All the people we were overlooking. Hi, did you come from below by any chance? They say the road is infested with monsters. You're lucky to have gotten here unhurt. Oh, that's our expertise. If you are tired, take a rest at the inn. Oh yeah, Professor Maggot. These drinks taste better, especially when I had to skip my lectures to get it. What a refreshing taste and rich aroma, much better than the words of great scholars. Whenever I'm happy, worried, or sad, this keeps me company. Well, that is sad. I can't give up drinking my precious drinks. You must. I will kill you. Hi there, what would you like to have? I'm sorry, but we don't have any of our usual stock from Baloa. We do have soft drinks, though. I came to purchase steel again, but I got stuck because the highway to Baloa is infested with monsters. No adventurers are available. What should we do? Shipment of seafood from Baloa has stopped, but we still have tons of meat and vegetables. If you get hungry, I can cook for you anytime. Then begin the cooking. Jesus, gonna... Do you need a room? Please come to the counter. Do we need a room? No. No, we don't. Oh, there's Rutice. Rutice is brooding over something, wearing a sad look. Rutice, says Avon. Avon, have you finished talking to people at the factory? No, not yet. I'll be waiting for you here. I'm sorry I'm selfish. Well, she's like really upset. I wish I could reassure her, but I do not have the option to do so. This lady. Hi, Avon. Nice to see you. It's a perfect timing. I know a great girl for you. She works in the cafeteria in New Boren. She is a draw girl who is kind and a good cook. What's a draw girl? People queue every day just to see her. Avon says thank you, but try someone else. And then down here she had some books. They have the same books. Yeah. Easy recipes with eggs. They're the silliest books to make videos out of, but there's someone out there who liked most of my recipe books. Like, I got one like on, like, most of them. And whoever that is, I really appreciate you. I'm surprised I didn't get dislikes on them back when you could even see dislikes. Oh, I can't get back to the counter. Well, who do we have here? Hello, Avon. It's been a while. Where is Mile? Well, something happened. You sound serious. Anyway, if you need a job, come to see me anytime. Monsters showed up in the mine, but all our adventurers are busy. Well, he didn't press on it about what happened to Mile. I'm sure Avon's glad for it. He doesn't like talking about it. I'm sorry, come to the counter, will you? Yeah, you're, I don't think you have anything we want to buy. Hi there, we have quality goods. Can you please come to the counter now? Welcome. If you need anything, my husband can help you. Alright, that's it for that. It's a good song. I like it. Ah, I fell off. Is this... I thought it was like another way out of the city. Hey, Avon. It's been a while. Rouca will be very happy to see you. Rouca went out to take a look at the mine. I'm sure he is back by now. Hey, Avon. Rouca and the plant manager wanted to see you. Do visit them before you go. Yep, I'm gonna go visit them. Take a look around the perimeter here. That wasn't like that before. That track and this wall like this? I don't remember it being like that. Cat. Rouca put in the most effort to restore the factory after it was destroyed. All blast furnaces are working now because of Rouca and the efforts of others who were inspired by him. He is such a great kid. Oh, this thing is on our way. Oh, we can just walk over the... Okay. So some of them we can walk over, some we can't. Hello, it's nice to see you again. Did you come to see Rouca? I think he is in the plant manager's office now. Rouca redesigned the HF1 furnace from scratch by consulting the engineers. A lot of ideas came from him. The damages caused by the explosion have finally been repaired, although the control unit is still old and the deterioration of some blast furnaces has accelerated. Well, we should think forward and be positive. Yeah, I remember there's like an entrance to some kind of dungeon or something over here. The mine ahead is excavating rare metal now, but the excavation is not going smoothly because of frequent encounters with stray monsters. At some point, we're going to be going in there, I'm sure. Alright, how do we get down again? I'm like walking into gears and stuff. Ah, here we go. I think that door is the way in. I just want to see if there's anyone else hanging around. Thank you. Plant Manager Castle. Oh, you. Rouca says, Aven. Aven says, Rouca, Plant Manager, it's been a while. You two look good. Rouca says, Aven, we heard about Mile and Emel. I don't know what to say. So you know. Plant Manager says, Sage Gawain told us when we consulted him about the rare metal sword. Aven, I'm truly sorry. I'm not over with it yet, but I have things to do. I'll be fine. If I can get a hold of a sword that seals in Bardas's power, I can rescue Emel. Lucia says, Plant Manager, do you think you can make the sword? We were making little progress, but finally we are beginning to see light. However, we must have spell power to process rare metal into a sword. Rouca says, besides, monsters began showing up in the Guia mine. We don't have enough rare metal ores to make a sword. Lucia says, it sounds like we still have many problems. Aven asks, is there anything we can help you with? Plant Manager says, well, as for the processing of rare metal, I was thinking about asking help from the Sorcery School. I just came from there. I would appreciate it if you could deliver this letter to President Sion of the Sorcery School. Consider it done, says Aven. Aven was entrusted with a manager note. Lucia says, by the way, did you ask the guild to exterminate the monsters in the mine? Yes, we did. I guess they are short of people. As soon as adventurers are available, they will send them to the mine. Lucia says, then why don't I exterminate the monsters? I'm an adventurer too. Can you do it all by yourself? Aven says. Who do you think I am? I was taught my master castle. Oh, so we got castle, and then we got plant manager castle, spelled different ways, but pronounced the same, I'm assuming. A disciple of Castle, the saint of the swords, then you must be the famous Sapphire Eyes. I'm sure you'll take care of the monsters easily. Well, I'm flattered. Anyway, I was offered and I have accepted the job officially. I'll go to the mine to exterminate the monsters. Aven, you leave for the Sorcery School at once. Roger, says Aven. Alright then, could you please show me the way to the mine, Plant Manager? I'll take you to the entrance. You just walk past there. Rouca, please look after the factory while I'm gone. Yes, I will. Please be careful. So we're gonna play by... Are we gonna play What's-Her-Name by herself? And then play Aven by himself? He says, alright, I'll leave for the Sorcery School too. I hope Rael and Professor Eleanor are doing well. Rael is still a mischievous prank, says Rouca. He does attend classes though. Aven, chuckling, Professor Eleanor must be having a hard time. Ugh. Aven, what is it? Have you seen my sister after that? No. I'm worried about her. She seems to be involved in some kind of dangerous plot. I'm afraid she is forced to commit crimes against her will. You don't have to worry about that, says Aven. How do you know? I just know. Your sister is not a bad person. She should know that what Octum's apostles are doing is wrong. Thank you, Aven. I'm encouraged. That's the least I can do. Anyhow, I better head for the Sorcery School. I'll come back with supports, so stay put. Okay, see you soon. There has been an increase in the number of monsters sighted along the highway. I don't think any monster can give you a hard time, Aven, but do be careful. Rael and Professor Eleanor were wanting to see you, too. Yeah, I didn't see Professor Eleanor there. She's usually downstairs, and I couldn't find a downstairs. Let's go check by the mine entrance here. The plant manager went into the Guia mine together with a pretty swordswoman. They say she is a famous adventurer. She was so cool and dashing. I guess we're not going in there. I thought we were going to be. So it's Aven by himself now. That's crazy. Let me through. Are you going to the Sorcery School? They say recently monsters are showing up frequently along the highway, too. Be careful. Of course, I don't think any monster can give Aven a hard time. Oh, shucks. Many damages by monsters are being reported lately. Nothing good has happened ever since the factory was blown up. I should eat something delicious to cheer myself up. Alright, I'm not gonna check with everybody else. Let's see. I'm going back to the Sorcery School, actually. I'm only assuming that if we go back now, they don't have the book. I don't know. Alright, but let's read it. And that'll finish off the episode. So if anyone wants to tune out now, go right ahead. Swordmaster 9. Volume 9, The Decision. The next morning, the Red Tribe and Milligan's army assembled in the field covered with morning mist. Milligan, sitting astride his dragon Arverheat, looked through the mist at the enemy's silhouette. The time has come for the final battle against the Swordmaster. The formation of Milligan's army showed the strength of Milligan's leadership. On the other hand, the Red Tribe maintained their appearance as an army, but the formation didn't seem quite as solid. Zamza stood in the lead. All the other soldiers' eyes seemed vacant. As Tempest explained the night before, they were no longer obeying Zamza. They were mere zombies moving under Tempest's commands. When the sunlight shone its morning rays from the top of the mountains, both forces clashed at each other. Zamza jumped into the crowd of enemies, as usual, with his sword in hand. But that was where the similarity ended. He advanced through his opponents while slashing at them with his sword. He went farther into his enemy line. Zamza ran through by himself while swinging his sword. His eyes that fixed upon the enemies had a certain determination in them. Not a single tribesman followed in the wake of Zamza. Even if they were in control of themselves, no one could probably keep up with Zamza. Only Zamza advanced to his opponents. He knocked the arrows that flew at him with his arms. And he sent multiple opponents tumbling with a single swing of his sword from atop his steed. He'd look like a god of war. He had one purpose after hearing about the hopeless situation of his people. In order to achieve his purpose, he advanced, never looking back, knowing what he is doing is irrational. The Swordsmaster is coming! Yelling and screaming filled the Milligan's army. But Zamza was showing signs of fatigue from knocking his enemies down constantly. There were multiple arrows in his back and legs. The tip of a blade stuck out from his right chest. That sounds painful. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys, or I guess we're going back to the Sorcery School again. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.